Hello, good evening. Hello, Rosie. Hello, Lisette.
Hello, teacher.
Hi, how are you today, Rosie? How was your day?
Descansando, por fin.
Ah, your rest. Congratulations. I hear kids. Escucho niños. Sí. Do you have children in your house?
Sí, tengo uno.
Ah, okay. How old? Is a boy.
Es un niño, 7 años tiene.
7. Ah, okay. And is he very energetic?
Terriblemente.
Ah, okay, Rosie. I imagine. But nice to have you here. And it's good that you're resting. Qué bueno que ya descansan. Yeah, ya aquí ready to study. Okay, hi, Katia. Sí. Enjoy your meal, Marisela. What are you eating? Frijolitos. No, beans.
Soup.
Ah, okay, cool.
Soup of chicken.
Chicken soup. Okay, cool. What is your favorite soup? ¿Cuál es su preferida? What is your favorite soup?
Chicken.
Chicken. Ah, ok, cool. Ok, Marisela, pues cuando termine de comer, si quiere ahí le hablo y eso, ok, para que pueda comer ahí tranquila. But it's good. Thank you for being here on time. Hello, Rafa. You look different.
Hello,
you look
teacher.
Different. I yes. know your shape. Parece como que le han quitado años de encima. Without your...
Thank you.
So, do you usually shave, or how often do you shave? How often do you shave?
Depende.
Ah, okay.
Usually, one a week.
Once a week?
Sí.
Ah, okay. Yes. Okay, good. Okay, well, nice to have you. Where are you? Are you in your house? I see many colors on the background.
Yes, in my house. Ah, my wife is seller, vende, de vender.
Sales? Uh-huh, seller.
Sales. Uh-huh.
Ah, okay, so she has the
artículos,
products.
Yes, para decoraciones. Okay. Para fiestas.
Ah, okay. You can say that it's decoration for parties. Uh-huh. It looks very, very colorful. Se ve así bien colorido.
Sí. Uh-huh. Sí. Okay. Y es que estaba ocupando la sala y me tocó mover.
Uh-huh. Yes. Okay. Well, I have to take the attendance. I'm going to take the attendance right now and then we continue with some activities. Okay, so today is August 31st. Okay, Daisy Mezquita.
Present.
Thank you. Doris Castaneda. Iris Román. Jennifer Marcela. José Mario. Katia Hernández.
Present.
Thank you. Lizeth Pineda. Marisela del Carmen.
Present.
Thank you. Mauricio Castaneda. Minette Rivera. Nehemías. Regalo. Nelson Alberto. Nelson René. Rafael Antonio.
I'm here, present.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going
to... Present.
All right. And then René Guardado. Rina Espinosa. Rosy Meléndez.
Present.
Thank you. Vladimir Rodas. Yanira Cepeda. And Zulma López. Okay, so now that I have taken the attendance, we can continue. This activity is about vocabulary. Okay, it's about vocabulary. I'm going to tell you a letter and you have to think about 10 words with the letter I say. I'm going to type the instruction here. You have to think about, one moment, think about 10 words with the letter I give you, okay? Think about 10 letters with the letter I will give you. For example, letter M. And then you have to think about 10 words with letter M that start with M. Entonces, el primero que termine, el primero que encuentre 10 palabras con la letra M, dice stop, okay? You have to say stop and you read the words. Do you understand the activity? Or do you have questions?
10 palabras con la letra M.
Yes, correct. If you finish, say stop. Like if you have them, you can say stop. Mom, mother, money, make, melt, and you continue. 10, okay? But this is just an example. Okay, now we go for real.
Okay, hello everyone.
Hi Rene, hello.
I'm sorry, I just get in. What is the activity?
Oh, I don't worry, it's good that you're here. The activity is about vocabulary. I'm going to say a letter. You have to think about 10 words with the letter I will present. If you finish, say stop and read your words.
That's 10 what... words with the letter that you say. Okay, okay.
Yes, which... but I'm about to type it here. Okay, so letter K. Letter K. I see you cut your hair. Looks good.
Yes, I actually I did. Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm going to let you think about them, about the words.
About those. Okay, great. Thank you.
It's they change look.
Uh-huh. Yes, you are also shaped. So yes, it's also different.
I look a little more older. I mean, I have a lot of tanas. So...
You have a gray hair. That's the way you
gray
can say
hair.
It.
Hair.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's
but
right.
I can't
here,
see it.
Right here.
But I can't see it, so that's nice. That's good about the camera.
All right, yeah, great.
And remember, when you finish, say stop. And you have to say the words that you have. Say the word stop. Good evening,
finish, teacher.
Jeremias. Hello. Oh, okay. Can you say them, Rosie? Your 10 letters.
Se las digo.
Please.
Milk, magic, mall, magazine, mail, man, many, marsh, map, maybe.
Okay, Rosie. That's okay. Solo que la M era solo de prueba, Rosie. The word is K. Esta es la verdadera. Okay, but...
Ah, okay. Okay.
Sorry,
sorry.
No problem. So, Nehemias, I'm going to explain the activity. I type it here I give you a letter of the alphabet and you have to think about 10 words with the letter I give you. Your classmates are trying to have 10 words that start with K. Do you understand? I don't hear you, Nehemiah.
Okay, teacher.
You do? Okay. So that is what we are doing. Is there anybody ready? 10 words? Katia, ready? Katia, ready?
Todavía me faltan dos.
Ah, okay, ya casi, almost done. Daisy, are you speaking? I don't hear you. Daisy, no sé si está hablándome, porque no la oigo. No.
Yes.
Ah, okay, tell me.
Keep.
Ajá.
Kitchen.
Ajá.
Rodillas.
Knee.
King, kitty, ketchup.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Daisy. Okay, guys, stop. Next letter. I'm going to change the letter. Voy a cambiarla, ya no sigan con K. Okay, easy. W. Letter W. 10 words.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, sounds cool. Can you say them, please? Rafa.
Walk, wall, wallet, want, war, warm, water, we, weak, weird.
There you go. Okay, correct. Thank you. Okay, so stop. Next letter. Okay, letter. Yes, sorry. Marisela, did you have a comment? No.
Sí, yo tengo watermelon, work, welcome, window. Ahí se puede poner word, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
Y what.
Yes, that's
watch it.
Yes, they are correct too. Okay, so next one. Let's go with letter Y. Letter Y. How are you doing? Mías, ya casi. Two, you're missing two. René, how many are you missing?
Four, right?
Four in this moment. Ah, okay. So you're almost done. Hi, Nelson. Welcome to the class. Hello, Rina. We are in the middle of a competition in this moment. Just hold on a moment, Nelson and Rina. Okay, so it looks like we have a winner. Katia, you finish. Okay, tell us.
Teacher.
Ajá, Rosy.
Una ya no encuentro. Solo nueve tengo.
Okay, Katia has 10. She's going to give you more ideas. Yes, Katia. What do you have?
Sería yellow. Young. Young como
young. Point. Young.
Young. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yesterday. Yogurt. Younger. Year. Yoga. Mm-hmm. Your. Mm-hmm. You.
Okay, there you go. Well, congratulations. So that way you can exercise your memory, your vocabulary. Okay, so we will continue. Nehemias, you were very close. You were missing just one more letter. Yes, Nelson? Alberto? Do you have a... Just activate the microphone, Alberto. Just I don't hear you. Ah, okay. I still don't hear you, Albert. Maybe it's a connection problem because it doesn't sound good. If you want to send me a message, because I think your connection is low in this moment. That's a good idea. Alberto, no se le entiende. No sé si me escucha, pero no se entiende. Si quiere, mándeme un mensaje. Porque no se oye bien. Se oye como el de Dory buscando a Nemo, right? A veces. Okay, so let's continue, guys. We, by the way, remember tomorrow, that is the last day of unit number 2. So remember to complete your section, your activities in the platform. What is the objective of this class? Is that you can express obligations or needs, necessities in your workplace or at your job. So we will start by asking this question to some of you. Zulma, what are some of your obligations at your workplace, Zulma? What are some of your obligations?
Hi, teacher.
Hi. What are some of your obligations? Raro, yes, I hear you, but it doesn't sound very well. Or send me a message. Send me a message, Zulma.
Okay.
Okay, let's continue with Daisy. Can you tell us some of your obligations, Daisy?
Ahorita le quedé en mi trabajo.
Obligations or responsibilities that you have, Daisy?
No sé si está bien decir dispensing o medication. No.
You tiene que dar medicina, eso es lo que quiere decir.
Ajá, o sea, tengo que despachar los clientes.
Okay, you can say that you have to, I have to deliver medicine or give medicine to customers. I have to give.
I have to give
medicine.
Medicine
to customers.
Medicine.
Mm-hmm. To customers. Yes.
Otra cosa, facturar.
You have to make bills.
La última palabra.
Bills, like the name bill, but with S. I will send it in the chat.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Y la otra es, no sé si se pronuncia, look out for stock.
Look out, but what do you want to say? What do you mean, Daisy? ¿Qué quiere decir? What do you mean?
Mantener la vitrina con esto.
Ah, okay.
No.
Okay, I will say that you have to stock the shelves. I have to stock shelves of the pharmacy. This is shelves of the pharmacy. Okay, Daisy, thank you very much for your comment. Nelson and you, can you tell us some obligations that you have in your company?
Nelson René, ¿verdad?
Yes, you, Nelson.
Okay. Obligation is my obligation is same report of cashier. La vez pasada creo que me dijo cuadratura, ¿cómo diría?
I'm going to mute you just to tell you, because when you speak, I hear my echo. Maybe in this moment, I don't remember the exact word. I was going to look for it, but maybe you can say that you check or you calculate the financial, the money, or you check the inflows and outflows, or you supervise the accounts. You can activate your microphone again, Nelson.
Okay.
Another activity.
Check money, eso. También translate information.
Translate.
Sí.
What do you mean?
Claro, aparte de eso, he trasladado la información a los cajeros a través de email.
Okay, use transfer or give.
For give. Cajeros, supervisor. The operation of cashier también.
Okay. Use this. Supervise. I supervise the operations, or the cashier's operations. Supervisor is the person, and supervise is the verb, the activity.
Okay.
Supervisor es la persona, la ocupación, pero supervise es el verbo.
Entonces sería supervise.
Ajá.
Sí, supervise.
Yes. Okay, Nelson.
Sí. Okay.
Thank you for your comment too. And one last comment. What about you, Marisela? Can you tell me some obligations you have?
My obligation is send a report vouchers, call llamar a proveedores.
Call providers. I have to call providers.
Call providers. I have call providers. Ingresar compras a sistemas, ¿cómo sería?
Input information. I have to input information in the system or in my computer.
Okay, entonces sería I have input information in the system. La otra sería como tramitar autorizaciones de compra.
I process selling authorizations. I'm going to send it in the chat. I process, or I have to process selling authorizations. That's the way you can say it. Or purchase authorizations. Okay, Marisela. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's continue. We will continue with the conversation to practice pronunciation, John and Anne. So it says, Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow? Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you? Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today. Oh, that's too bad. Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers. That sounds interesting. Okay, so now it is your turn. We will start with Nehemias. Nehemias, you are John, and Rina, you are Anne.
Okay. Anne, is there some time you need to do tomorrow?
Yes. Actually, I need to call some clients, and you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meeting for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
Okay, thank you, Rina and Nehemias. I'm going to help you with the pronunciation. I highlighted some words. Okay, this one here is clients. That is the pronunciation, clients. Okay, and the one here is reschedule. Can you try to say it? Reschedule.
Cancel.
Reschedule.
Reschedule. Mm-hmm. And here is canceled. Imagine that we remove the E. We don't say it. Canceled. That is the way it sounds. And the last one here, the last word is interesting.
Interesting.
Okay, thank you very much, Trina and Demis. Let's continue with Rosie and Rene. Rosie, you are N, and Rene, you are John.
Okay. Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients, and you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
Interesting.
Okay, thank you, Rene. Thank you very much. Rosie as well. Let's continue with Rafa. Rafa and Katia. Rafa, you are John, and Anne, Katia.
Okay. Anne, is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes. Actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled today.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
Okay, very good. Good pronunciation, guys. So we will continue with Zulma. Zulma, is your connection better? Zulma, or not yet? I guess not. Zulma, can you hear me?
Hola, teacher.
Yes. Okay, Zulma, you are John, and Daisy, you are Anne.
Okay. Is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They were canceled, right?
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide important information to some consumers.
That sounds interesting.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. Okay, Zulma, thank you, and thank you, Daisy. Now, Nelson and Maricela. Nelson, you are John, and Maricela, you are Anne.
Okay. Is there something you need to do tomorrow?
Yes, actually, I need to call some clients. And you?
Well, I have to reschedule two meetings for tomorrow. They we cancel today.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yes, I have to provide information to some customers.
That sounds interesting.
Interesting. Yes. Thank you, Maricela, and thank you, Nelson. Okay, so here you have the word reschedule. It means to reprogram. Like you have to program an activity for a different date. You change the date of the activity. An example, classes. Imagine that tomorrow I have an emergency and I can't give the class. I can say I have to reschedule the class. We have to reprogram the class because I can't come tomorrow. Okay, you cancel or you change the date of the activity. Is it clear? Or no? ¿Entendieron que era reschedule? Or no? You didn't. And you, Maricela?
Como dice que es reprogramar, es como volver a hacer lo que ya se tenía, pero de otra forma diferente.
You change the date, cambia las fechas de algo, por X, Y razón. But yes, it means to reprogram. ¿Sí entendió?
Como que tiene que reprogramar sus reuniones, ¿verdad? Para mañana.
Yes. Okay. So, do you have any other questions about the vocabulary? Do you have questions, more questions about the vocabulary?
Tengo una.
Yes.
Which provide.
Okay. To provide is to give, but it sounds more formal. More formal than give, but it's the same. To give important information to customers.
Okay. Brindar.
Okay. Yes, that is the meaning you can give to provide. Anything else?
That's too bad.
That's too bad.
Yes.
That's too bad is an expression, Rafa, that you can use when you are sad, when you receive bad news, like the graduation was canceled and you want to express your sadness. Usted quiere expresar su tristeza, you can say, oh, that's too bad.
Estoy triste.
Puede significar eso, qué mal. Pero es como para expresar qué tristeza. Mal, correcto, como usted quiera, pero es para eso, para decir eso. Okay. ¿Estamos bien? You're welcome. ¿O hay alguna otra palabra? No.
I don't remember the donde dice that sounds interesting.
Okay, that is a phrase. It's also a phrase to show interest when something is interesting. So it is a phrase to show interest. Like, wow, that's, and then you say interesting.
Joder, y la otra sounds?
Sounds, suena.
Okay,
so now we will continue. Here we have some things that we will discuss. We're going to study how to use have to and need to. Okay, that is what we're going to study in this moment. So Katia, you had questions yesterday, right? So this is the moment. Okay, today we will study how to use have to and need to. In the book, as you can see here, you can express obligation, or you can express necessities, needs. Okay, so let's choose the whiteboard. Let's begin with have to. Now change the font of this. Okay, imagine that have to is a magic word to express obligation, okay? Have to is what you need to say to express obligations, responsibilities that you have. Just use have to. It's your magic word. Examples, I have to, and now the activity, the responsibility, the obligation that you have. I have to work. It is an obligation, right? You have to work. It is a responsibility. I have to pay the electricity bill. I'm going to put it here. The electricity bill or the water bill. It is an obligation. can you mention one obligation that you have? This is the magic word. You say have to, and now you mention the activity, the obligation that you have. Okay, one moment, Maricela, let me refresh it. Maybe now you can see it. So you have to say, I have to, and then mention the obligation, something that you have to do. Ideas? Obligations?
I have to dispatch the client.
Okay. We can say that I have to assist clients or customers. Thank you, Rina. That is an obligation. Or at home, can you say some obligations? It could be an obligation, Katia. I have to study English. So it is like a responsibility. You use have to. But remember that this is simple present. Acuérdense que estamos siempre en simple present. Es un verbo. Y acuérdense que tenemos un cambio para tres sujetos, ¿verdad? He, she, it. Do you remember the form of have to? ¿Se recuerdan cómo va have to con terceras personas?
Have.
That is correct. Has to. It is the same, but this is for he, she, and it. Like if you talk about, imagine my mom or my dad, my husband, my boyfriend, you have to use has. Examples. My dad or my mom, and one obligation or responsibility. My mom has to, and then you mention the activity, has to cook in the house. One example, just an example, something that is common. Or I can say that has to work. Okay, has to and have to are the same, but have to is for I, you, we, and they, and has to for he, she, and it. I will give you more examples, but I have them over here. Okay, here we have more examples, you have more subjects, and I will say a longer explanation about the use of have to. Can you read this, Daisy, please? The meaning or the use of have to.
Okay. Have to indicate personal obligation or personal
necessities. You can also use have to give or to say necessities you have. I have some examples here in the affirmative form. Okay, Nelson, can you read these examples, please?
Okay. I have to pay bill. We have to work. Children have to obey their parents. Moms have to cook for their family.
Thank you, Nelson. So here we have to. And now here you have examples with has to. Maricela, can you read the examples, please? Then the last examples.
My mom has to clean the house. His dad has to work every day. My son has to make his bed. Her manager has to give a
presentation.
Presentation.
Thank you. So here you have a mix of obligations and some necessities, like a personal necessity. Yes, Rafa, tell me.
I have a question.
Yes.
Moms have to cook.
Mm-hmm.
¿Por qué no es has o children have? No, pienso que se está refiriendo a una tercera persona.
But is, remember, it is a singular noun. Only one woman. Mom. But moms is many, many women. Son varias mujeres, moms. Rafa.
Uh-huh. Moms. Ajá. Okay.
Pero así como acá, que ya es mom.
Perdida ahí un poquito. Ajá.
No, it's okay. Siempre okay. Que hay alguna duda, pregunta. Así se sale de esa duda. Ajá. So, okay. Thank now, you're welcome. The negative form. If you want to create negative sentences, use simple present in the negative forms. I have to pay the bills. Negative form. I don't. We use does, doesn't, or don't, right? I don't have to pay bills. I don't have to pay bills. My dad has to pay bills. My husband has to pay bills. We have to work. Kids don't have to work. Okay, that is the negative form. And my mom has to clean the house with he, she, and it. My son has to make his bed. One negative sentence. I'm going to type it here. My son doesn't have to work. That is the negative form. Okay, siempre se sigue la misma estructura. La misma estructura que hemos estado viendo de simple present, ¿verdad? Porque siempre es un verbo. Have to. Yes? No? Questions?
Teacher, ahí le puso my son doesn't have to work.
Mm-hmm.
No sería my son has to work.
No, porque acuérdese que cuando es negativo o pregunta, se elimina la regla de la S. Solo se pone con S o con tercera persona en afirmativo. Questions or negative sentences? No. That is why. What is the question? La pregunta también la vamos a hacer como normalmente lo hemos hecho. Solo tienen que utilizar have to. For example, do you have to work every day? Okay, and that is a question, okay? Se utiliza la estructura de una pregunta, la que hemos estado viendo. Con terceras personas no es tú, sino que ya sería does. Does Rina have to, Rina, okay, have to pay bills? Okay, como es tercera persona, ya utilizo does. Rina have to pay bills. Okay, so it is the same structure, ¿verdad? Seguimos la misma estructura de simple present. Okay, creo que todavía se acuerdan, right? Sí, yes. Okay, so that is the way we use have to. I'm going to go to the next presentation. About need to. Okay, Nehemiah, can you read the explanation about need to.
Okay. Need to. Indicators, necessities or obligations. Mm-hmm. I need to pay my bills, my boss needs me to call customers, he needs to go to the bathroom.
Yes, thank you, Nemias. Okay, so need to expresses or is your magic word to express a necessity that you have. Depending on the context, it could be a necessity or like an obligation, okay? Now, Katia, about the question you asked yesterday. There is maybe a slightly different. Casi no hay diferencia. Depende de lo que se quiera decir. I can say, I have to go to the bathroom. Or you can say, I need to go to the bathroom. Depending on the context, it could be an obligation or a necessity. Dependiendo de lo que diga usted, Katia, ahí sería como una necesidad la que se está diciendo o como una obligación, ¿verdad? Como también have to puede expresar personal necessities, necesidades personales. So you can say, I have to go to the bathroom, or I need to go to the bathroom. And it's pretty much the same, Katia. They're pretty much saying the same thing. Okay, so las podría intercambiar. But need to indicates necessities. And have to, mostly obligations. I have, let me check something here. When you use need to, you are saying that it's necessary. That is what you are expressing, that is necessary. And when you use have to, it's like an obligation that you have. So just to recap, pueden utilizar cualquiera de los dos, depende de qué quieran decir. ¿Verdad? Si quieren decirlo con have to como una obligación o responsibility, o need to en el caso que sea una necesidad, ¿verdad? So I don't know if it's clear or not yet. What do you think? Questions? No. No question. Okay, can you give me two examples? One example using have to and one example using need to. I'm going to give you a moment so you can create the example. Two examples.
René? Two examples for each one or two examples one for...
In total.
I have to or I need to.
In total, one and one. One using have to and one using need to.
So I can say I have to be on meeting every day at 8 p.m. for mm-hmm. my English class.
Mm-hmm.
Because I need to improve my English to get a better job.
Correct. So you're like implying a necessity and an obligation or a personal necessity too, right? To study English because it's something that you want to do.
Okay. That's correct.
Thank you. Good examples. Who else is ready? Who else has an example?
Sería, I have to make my bed every morning.
Mm-hmm.
I need to brush my teeth.
Correct. And you need to brush your teeth every day too. Thank you, Katia. Rafa or Nehemiah? Are you ready?
I need eat a fruit.
Mm-hmm.
I have to drink water.
And you have to drink water. Yes. Thank you, Rafa. Nehemiah?
I have to exercise. I need to eat healthy.
Correct. Yes. Both are fine. Rina, are you ready?
I have to work every day.
Mm-hmm. And with need to?
I need sleep.
I need to sleep. Like 7 hours. Or more time.
More time.
Mm-hmm. Correct. Thank you, Rina. Maricela, can you continue?
Similar, I need to sleep every
day. And we have to, Maricela?
I have to work every day.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yes. Day. Thank you, Maricela. They are correct. Let's see, Zulma, what about you? Zulma, are you there? Or Daisy, are you ready?
I have to finish my work. You need to wash your car.
Yes. Thank you, Daisy. And Rosy. Sorry, Daisy, do you have a question?
Sí. Podría como diferenciar de que I need es como para necesidades externas. Y need to es como para, no sé, como para necesidades internas.
No, it could be used in both ways. Podría que need to, a veces sea que alguien se lo está pidiendo, a veces, pero no siempre. Y a veces el need to podría tornarse como una obligación, ¿verdad? Depende del contexto. Así que para las dos cosas, Daisy, need and have to. Okay, yes, Rosie, what are your sentences?
I need to drink coffee in the morning. I have to fill my shelf today.
You need to drink coffee in the mornings.
Yes.
What happens if you don't drink coffee?
Me duermo.
Ah, okay. You need the coffee. Okay. Thank you. Guys, I'm going to take the attendance because it's 9 already, so I will do it now. Okay. So we start with Daisy Mezquita.
Present.
Okay. Doris de Castaneda. Iris Joana. Jennifer Marcela. And then Jose Mario. Katia Gabriela.
Present.
Thank you. Lizette del Carmen. Maricela del Carmen.
Present. Then,
thank you. Mauricio Castaneda. Minette Rivera. Nehemías. Regalo. Present. Thank you. Present. Nelson Alberto. Nelson René.
Present.
Thank you. Then Rafael Antonio.
Present.
Thank you, René Guardado.
Present.
Okay. Rina Espinosa.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Rosy Meléndez.
Present.
Vladimir Antonio. Yanira, Lisette, and Zulma. Okay, so now it's time to work with the worksheet. I'm going to tell you about the worksheet, but let me look it up. I will tell you what we will be doing in groups of three. It's loading in this moment. Okay. Okay, so you have to fill in the blanks to complete the sentences. You have the sentence and you have to complete it using have to. Podría ser have to, has to, don't have to, doesn't have to, or does he or does she have to. Entonces podría ser una oración afirmativa, negativa o pregunta. Con terceras personas o normal. Okay, so you have to read and complete the sentences. Questions about the activity, about the worksheet? ¿Una duda about it? No. Okay, so I'm going to tell you who you will be working with. Let me see. Okay, Daisy, Zulma, and Rina. Daisy, Zulma, and Rina. Next, we will have Katia, René, and Rafa. Next, let me see, Marisela, Nehemías, Nelson, and Rosy. Okay, so please open the room. Hello, is there something I can help you with or not yet? No, no necesitan ahorita. Ayuda.
No. ¿Verdad que eso está con need to, have to y las negativas?
No, just have to. Solo con have to son todas. Okay. Ok, bueno, entonces en ese caso las voy a dejar que sigan. Y otras veces cualquier cosa me avisa. Ok, you're welcome.
Need to go.
My mom need to go.
Sorry, guys. It's only have to. Yeah. Just have to.
It just have to.
Uh-huh. Only have to. Need to, no. I mean, if you want to use it, but this worksheet is just to practice have to.
Oh, I see, I see. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because on some point I noticed that most of the cases are something that you need to do because you have to do it.
Yes.
But there is some exception there that we can use actually need.
Uh-huh. Which it will work like, well.
For example, the number two.
Mm-hmm.
Take,
yes, Katia.
En la tarea de ayer, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Decía la, creo que una frase era que mi mamá tiene que ir de shopping, ¿verdad? Y se escogía I need to, ¿verdad? Entonces ahí no entendería muy bien.
I'm going to open the platform and I'm going to check the one you're talking about. La voy a abrir. If you want to continue, voy a abrir esa section. Era de ayer, sería, ¿verdad, Katia?
La número uno sería.
Number one. Okay. My mother goes shopping. She doesn't have red shoes. You can say, depending on what you want to say, if it is a necessity, I will go with needs. My mother needs to go shopping. She doesn't have red shoes. Needs to. Yes, you can use, depending on what you want to say. I will say she needs to, but if it's like an obligation, por alguna razón, tiene que hacerlo, she has to.
Tiene que,
she has to
tiene que hacerlo porque no tiene zapatos. Pero ahí decía okay. Que era necesidad, ¿verdad?
So, tal vez para un evento, right? A wedding or... I don't know, something very fancy, you will go with has to. I don't have the right blouse, I have to buy one. So depending on the context, you can use have to and it needs to. Casi que no varía, no varía mucho el significado.
Ahorita trabajamos solo con have.
Uh-huh. Sí, los okay. Voy a dejar si quieren para que continúen.
Okay.
Y en un ratito los vengo a visitar again. Ok, see you.
All right.
Porque, o sea, porque has to, tiene que.
Preguntarlo.
Hello.
Ajá.
Do you have questions?
Hello, teacher. Yes.
Ajá.
Creemos que acá esta ya está completa.
Number five.
Yes.
Really.
And number seven.
Yes. Sorry. No me di cuenta. I'm sorry. La respuesta no. Mejor. ¿Cuál otra? ¿Cuál era la otra?
La cinco y la siete.
También. Seven. Ajá. Mm-hmm. Mary. No. It's not a mistake. No, es un error. ¿Hay algo que le pueden poner?
Ni tú. No,
no, pero igual. Bueno, no, pero sí tendría es, si fuera sí, negativa, porque, tendría sí, que ajá, ser have.
Ajá, no, igual porque dice que sí, si se context. Siente enferma.
Ajá, es cierto. Si se sí. Siente enferma. Pues sí. Esa ya está. Solo hola, eran esas dos.
Hasta el momento solo esa.
Hasta el momento.
No, creo que solo esas son. Ajá. Number three.
Lo hemos puesto como obligación, pero no sé si podría ir need.
This exercise has been designed just to use has, have to. Este solo lo creé para usar have to. Need to, no.
Oh.
Okay.
I have.
Ajá. Do you okay. have any other questions? Pero sí, sí, en caso lo ven otra vez have to, así como en number 7 or number 5, it's a typo, un error de digitación. Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Anything else to help you with? No. Okay, so in that case, I'm going to go away. ¿En cuál van ahorita? Like number 5, number 7.
7.
Okay, quizás. Okay, maybe como en 3 minutos, quizás, ¿verdad? Vamos a regresar al otro room. Okay, see you in a moment. Bye.
Bye.
Hi everyone, welcome back. So I brought you back so we can check or answer together the statements just to make sure that we have the same information. Okay, let's start with group number 1, Daisy. Can you help us with number one, please?
Today is a holiday.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go to work.
Yes, thank you. Group two, Katia. What is the question, Katia?
Does your sister has to go to the school today?
Does your sister has to?
Has to.
Okay, have to. Because it is a question. Just that. Besides that, it's good. Group number three,
okay.
Maricela.
Ahí le pusimos, my mom has to go to the post office now.
Yes, has to. And here also to. Sorry, I didn't put it. Okay, group number one again. Rina, help us, please. Number four. Rina?
Perdón, pensé que te... I have to study for my English test tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. I have to. Okay, thank you, Rina. Now, Rafa, group two. I modified that one.
Number five.
Yes.
Okay. And do they have to get up early every morning?
Yes. Yes, and the answer?
They have to.
Uh-huh. Here you have two possibilities. You can say yes they have do. To, or yes, they do. And both are okay. Mm-hmm. Both will be fine.
Okay,
thank you, Rafa. Nehemias, number six.
Josh doesn't have to drive to the store. He can take the bus.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't have. Okay, thank you, Nemias. Number seven, it was answered, so I think that you saw it. Mary has to, right? That was the answer, it was there. Zulma, number eight. Zulma?
I have to
answer my phone. Okay, Zulma, thank you. And now we go back with René. Number nine,
do you have to leave soon?
Yes, do you have to? Okay, thank you. Let's go with Nelson.
Have to take.
My friend has to. Has to take a driving test because it is only one friend. Okay. Thank you, Nelson. Rosie, can you help us with number 10?
Camels have drink water for a long time.
Any other possibility, Rosie?
Don't have.
It's done because camels, they keep water inside them. Como los camellos no tienen que tomar tanta agua. Porque como que guardan o algo así en su joroba, right? Something like that. So camels don't have to drink water for a long time. So that will be the one. Number 12. Let's go with Daisy. My brother. The microphone, Daisy.
Okay. My brother has to see a dentist. She has an appointment.
Appointment. Yes. Thank you, Daisy. Now, Katia, number 13.
La palabra, la voy a decir
más. Astronauts.
Astronauts have to bring food and water into space.
Yes, they have to. Thank you, Katia. And then Maricela, number 14.
Do he
does
who does sorry does he have
yes to? Have to
now
and the answer
yes he does.
Okay, thank you, Maricela. And now Rina. Can you help us with the last one, Rina, please?
Es la 15, ¿verdad?
Mm-hmm.
Do you really have to make so much noise?
Yes. Okay, thank you. So those should be the answers you should have. Do you have questions? Or doubts about it? Comments? No? No questions? Katia?
Solo tengo una. Solo si no podría volver a decir por qué en la pregunta no se le agrega el has.
El has. Porque la regla dice que cuando uno pregunta, se eliminan la regla de la S con cualquier verbo, Katy. Cuando utilizamos does, sea like, love, la regla dice de que hay que utilizarlo en base form. Does he love, does he eat, y luego el complemento. Con todos los verbos.
Con todos.
Yes.
Gracias.
You're welcome. Okay, now we will continue here. We have two more activities to go. The one that you see here, number 4, is about you. It says that you have to write about something you have to or need to do these days. And it says when, what time, and where. Okay, you have to add these details. Example, I have to go to the dentist. I have to go to the dentist. When? On Monday. On Monday. What time? 9 a.m. or 9 o'clock. Where? At ease. Okay. That's an example. Think about four things you have to do. When you finish, okay, send it to me by chat or a picture on the group, and you continue in exercise number 5. You have to write activities that you have to do or need to do in your job specifically. Later, you have to create questions for one of your classmates because you are going to interview her. Okay. So, por si acaso, la primera parte, la parte 4, ahí van a escribir 4 actividades, por lo menos 4 actividades que ustedes tengan que have to do or need to do. Con have to and need to, ambos. Puede ser 2 y 2. Doesn't matter. Luego, si terminan, me mandan la foto o me lo mandan en el chat. Yo lo leo, lo reviso y continúan avanzando en este. Acá tienen que escribir actividades que tienen que hacer en el trabajo o necesitan hacer en el trabajo y elaborar preguntas para uno de sus compañeros con el que van a trabajar en un breakout room. Okay, así que si terminan activity number 4, comiencen a avanzar en la siguiente activity. Do you have questions about the assignments? Nehemias?
So you say that the first one is something like that we have to or we need to through the week. It doesn't matter which activity it is. And the second part on the number 5 is something for the work, actual activities that we do just on work.
Yes, that's right. And elaborate questions for your classmates. As many
how
as
many
you
questions?
Can, as many as possible in the while you wait for the others to finish, create questions that you will ask later on.
Got it.
Yes.
Thank you.
And Nehemias, what about you? Did you have a question, Nehemias? Or you, Nelson? Questions? No.
Tengo una. O sea que de la número 5, ¿verdad? Nuestra lista. Y esa misma lista, lo que nosotros hacemos, vamos a hacer las preguntas de eso mismo.
Not exactly.
O es diferente.
Diferente. O sea, hago mi lista y luego pienso en preguntas que le voy a preguntar, valga la redundancia, a mi compañero. Si trabajas con Rina, luego que ya hayas hecho tu lista, tienes un cuestionario, por decirlo así. Como, Rina, do you have to go to the doctor next week? O Rina, do you need to clean the house tomorrow? Y ya son, ya luego se apuntan las respuestas de Rina. Yes, Rina has to clean the house. Y ya utilizamos has to.
Okay.
Teacher.
Yes, Maricela.
Comprar es voy, voy.
Buy, comprar.
Ajá.
Ajá, buy. I will send it in the chat.
Okay. Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, Daisy, thank you for sending them by chat. The first list, Daisy, number two, I need to go to the bank. I need to go to the bank. And then let me check the other one. Sí, veo el espacio. And yes, at the bank. And here in this one, you can say at the pharmacy, at the bank, at home, and at home. Okay, thank you. Entonces, ahorita va a comenzar la siguiente parte, la parte 5.
Okay. And the was it Monday and Friday? ¿Cuál sería ahí la palabra que va en medio?
What para, do you mean?
Para decir un intervalo de
from Monday to Friday. I will send it in the group.
Okay.
Monday,
Friday.
Check the chat. I will send it there. From Monday to Friday, from 1 to 2.
Okay, thank you.
Let me check the other one. I need to go shopping on Sunday at 10 a.m. In the supermarket. I need to visit my friend on Saturday, 4 p.m. His house, or you can also say the name, Roberto's house, Anna's house. You can say it like that. I have to go to a meeting on Wednesday, 1 p.m. in my house. I have to go to the hospital on Monday. Yes, the sentences are good. These ones belong to Rosy, right? Rosy Melendez.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Rosy. Good job. Let's see, Rina. Rina, is it psicólogo what you want to say? Is that the word? Psicólogo. Okay. So it will be psychologist. Because it's a psicología. I will send it in the group, psychologist. And okay. Then I have to drop off my children at school at 7:30. I need to learn English well. I need to go to work every day. Yes, very good job. I will send the word psychologist in the group. Okay, there it is. Okay, Nemias, let's check yours. You have to present documents, you have to send reports, you need to pay the electricity bill. Okay. Just the only recommendation will be the preposition on, Nemias. That is the only change. On Thursday, on Saturday. That's the only change. Thank you, Nehemías. So, Nehemías, ahorita va a comenzar la otra parte, entonces. ¿O ya la tiene? No. Okay. All right. And let's see here.
Teacher. De la segunda parte, ¿cuántas tenemos que hacer más o menos? ¿Cuántas actividades?
Fíjese de que... alrededor de, en 5 minutos los voy a enviar al grupo para que se pregunten. Así que...
De 3 a 4 estaría bien. Sí.
Yes. Y las preguntas. Okay. ¿Qué tiene que hacer para su compañero?
Okay.
So guys, you have about five more minutes, okay, to complete the activities. The other list and questions for your classmate. Hello, Marisela.
Hello,
I'm going. Se le fue la señal. Se le. Y ahora sí la ve.
Sí.
Ok. Le voy a mandar unos comentarios en el chat de los. Lo que mando. Ok. This is change, number one, change the preposition on, no at. On September 20th, First you mention the month and then you mention the date. Primero va el mes en inglés, Maricel. Y luego el día. And then number two is correct. Number three, you have to say, I have to do. Section or unit two, I have to do tomorrow. I need to buy t-shirts next month on the weekend. On the weekend, I need to, drink coffee. Okay, just those comments.
Okay, teacher, thanks.
I will check yours, Katia, in the group. Okay, Katia, it looks good. Thank you. Okay, have you created the questions? ¿Ya tienen las preguntas para sus classmates?
Yeah. Ahí vamos a hacer la lista de las actividades. Y este, de esas actividades vamos a armar las preguntas.
No, o las preguntas son extras. Como la que le decía, do you have to work tomorrow? Do you need to clean the house? Pueden ser cualquiera. No hay una pregunta formal. Ajá, usted las puede crear basados en su imaginación, no en sus oraciones. O lista.
Ah, pero la lista solamente, digamos, si te he puesto 5 actividades, por ejemplo, solamente server clients.
Ajá, eso estaría bien. Entonces, si ya tiene su lista, solo falta ahora que los mande al otro room para que ustedes se pregunten. You ask questions at each other. Mm-hmm. I will do that right now, at least a few minutes. I'm going to create right now the pairs. Yes, Nehemiah.
Teacher, planilla.
¿Cómo payroll.
Sería? Payroll.
I will okay, send no. it in the, Sorry.
Payroll.
Planilla como de, okay. de lo de pago, ¿verdad?
Bueno. Sí, solo que sería como el reporte que se le envía al Seguro Social.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you can use that.
Igual.
I have to send the payroll to East.
Payroll. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Daisy, you are going to work with Katia. Daisy and Katia. And then we will have Maricela and Zulma, Nelson, you are going to work with Rafa, and then Nehemias and René, and last one, Rina and Rosy. Okay, please open the room at least a moment so you can ask questions. And then we will be back.
y las preguntas que nos tenemos que preguntar, ya las hice.
No.
Esas no. Okay.
And you, Katia, do you have the questions?
Sí, ya las tengo.
You have them. Okay, si quieres, pregúntale a Daisy entonces. En lo que. Porque a usted, Daisy, solo le falta su lista. Bueno, la lista y las preguntas, ¿verdad?
No, solo las preguntas. La lista ya la tengo.
Ah, en eso se quedó. Okay, so, Katia, can you ask her questions? I will listen to the questions and the answers.
Okay. Do you have to work?
I need to send at my boss. I have to write a report on Monday morning.
Sorry, Daisy. Sorry to interrupt you. You have to answer Katia's question. Usted tiene que contestar la pregunta de Katia. Lo que le preguntó. Katia, can you repeat, please?
Do you have to work?
What is the answer, Daisy? Do you have to work?
Yes, I have.
You can say, yes, I do, or yes, I have to.
Okay.
Continue, Katia.
Do you have to get up early?
Temprano, early.
Yes, I do.
Do you need to pay bills?
Do you need?
Pay bills.
Do you remember the word bills, Daisy? ¿Se acuerda de esa palabra? Bills. Yes.
Repeat answer for, please.
Do you need to pay bills?
Yes. Yes, I do.
De ahí la otra. Do you need go to?
Do you need to go to?
To go, okay. To go. Do you need to go to at home?
Sería así, to ¿verdad? Home. Do you to need home. To go? No. Do you need to go home?
Okay. Do you need to go home?
Yes, I do.
Okay, all right. Do you have more, Katia? Do you have more questions or is that it?
Solo hice cuatro.
Okay, but yes, good questions, just the comments I gave you. And Daisy no tiene, ¿verdad? No tiene ahorita.
Voy a hacer la hora.
Ok. En alrededor de 2 minutos vamos a regresar allá, al main room. Voy a dejarlas un momento. Ok, see you in a moment.
A tu jefe, ¿cómo se dice? Do you have some reports tomorrow?
Yes, I do. Send the report via email.
Ajá, voy a hacer un report tomorrow. Creo que quedaría como solo yes I do.
También. Pero si le envío los reportes vía correo electrónico.
Yes I do for the email. Entonces sería for them.
You can say yes, I send reports by email or via email or by email.
Yes, I send.
Solo que report. Si habla de Zulma, Marisela tendría que cambiarle. Zulma sends or she sends.
She, ajá, she. Sí, de Zulma estamos hablando ahorita.
Yes.
¿Te puede esta pregunta, teacher?
A ver, ¿cuál?
Como ella me preguntaba si yo tengo carro. Do you have two cars?
Do you have cars? Pero ahí no sería como una obligación o responsabilidad.
Ajá,
solo es pertenencia.
Ah, ok.
Tiene que ir con un verbo.
Ah, pues
ajá.
No, esta no va.
Esa no va.
Le pregunto que para su trabajo necesita carro, ya sí sería una obligación, sí. ¿Verdad?
Cabal. Ya sería, do you have to use, do you have to drive a car to work?
Para
do
trabajo,
you need?
To work. Ah, ok.
Ajá, eso le decía, porque al inicio se lo había preguntado como solamente si tenía el carro.
Ajá. Sí, eso es bueno, de que se ayuden entre ustedes, porque a veces uno no se percata hasta que alguien le dice y uno, ah, sí, sí, es cierto, ¿verdad? Y a uno ya, sí. Ya la agarra. Hi, welcome back. I hope you had enough time to practice with your classmate. And I will take the attendance before we go, just to double check. I sent the program or the schedule by chat. So let me see. Nelson, are you going to stay tonight? ¿Sí se va a quedar ahora, Nelson?
Yes. Sí.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. I'm just going to take the attendance and then you can go in a few seconds. Daisy Yesenia.
Present.
Thank you, Doris Guevara. Iris Joana, Jennifer Marcela, José Mario, Katia Gabriela.
Present.
Thank you. Lisette del Carmen, Marisela del Carmen.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Mauricio Castaneda, Minette Rivera, Nehemías Regalo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Then Nelson Alberto, Nelson René.
Present.
Okay. Rafael Antonio and René Guardado.
Present.
Okay. Thank you.
Present.
Rina Espinosa and Rosy Meléndez.
Present, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Vladimir and Yanira and Zulma López.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you everyone. So for now we will stop here. Recuerden mañana último día para terminar su tarea de la sección 2. Okay, so if you can finish today or tomorrow, I will appreciate it. So I hope you have a good night, that you can rest a lot, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Okay, so bye-bye everyone.
Okay.
See you
bye
tomorrow.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Take care, guys. See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Renee.
Una
you
pregunta.
Uh-huh, Katia.
Bye.
Bye.
Las listas se las mandamos al grupo, ¿o no? ¿O no?
Yes, yes. You can send it in the chat. And I check them
okay.
There.
Yeah.
Bye, Katia. Take care. Hello, Nelson. ¿Qué tal le ha ido?
Hello. Very good.
Very good. ¿Qué tal ha sentido el segundo nivel? ¿Siente más difícil? Fácil?
un poquito más difícil, la verdad. La verdad que sí. Siento que, bueno, sí, más que todo lo que siento que me ha costado un poquito son los adverbios de frecuencia.
Ah, eso siento que le cuesta.
La relación. Ajá, siento que la relación a la hora de hacer las oraciones.
¿Cómo así, René? Nelson.
En el caso, bueno, aquí había notado ya a la hora de incluir. A la hora de incluir el adverbio, ¿en qué momento incluirlo? En el caso, lo que me costaba a mí es el, please.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, Nelson. Don't worry.
Children.
Sí, no, no se preocupe. Okay. No tenga
lo que estaba, que le estaba mencionando de que me costaba cómo incluir o cómo diferenciar los adverbios de frecuencia a la hora de incluirlos en las oraciones o en los párrafos. No, en lo, a la hora que nos mandaba lo, cuando nos mandaba usted, y ahí me costaba un poco el cómo colocar el always, cómo relacionarlo con la oración en sí. Por un ejemplo, digamos, el always sí que sé que siempre, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Pero como no tengo demasiado muchas palabras, mucho vocabulario, ahí siento que me costaba relacionar los adverbios.
Ah, ok, entonces me dice que los entiende, pero que como no los usa mucho, le cuesta saber cuándo utilizarlos.
Exacto, exacto.
Ok. Uh-huh. Pues analizando eso, según lo que me dice, yo siento de que sería un poco más acá de memorizar, Nelson. Memorizarlos, porque lo que me dice es de que le cuesta saber cuándo ponerlo. Vale, voy a compartir aquí el libro. Vale. Y aquí están todos los frequency adverbs. Hay adverbs, ¿verdad? Y están las phrases, que eran expresiones, las que poníamos al final. Usted dice que estos son los que le cuestan.
Exacto. Vale. Always, no hay problema, and never, ¿verdad?
Eso
pero
ya.
Ya como, okay. Ajá, exacto, pero ya sometime and seldom, ahí sí, inclusive hardly ever.
Y utilizarlo sí puede hacer la oración, la posición y todo eso se recuerda. ¿Dónde van?
Un poco, no mucho.
Okay, repasemos eso y luego le voy a dar una recomendación. Tal vez le sirve para aprendérselos un poquito más. Bye. En este chart que ve acá, tiene la frequency y está explicado, ¿verdad? ¿Qué tan a menudo pasa cada actividad? Ok, la position. Estos adverbs van como en medio de la oración. Como usually, I can say I... Usually, one moment, I usually go to the doctor. So if you see here, we use the frequency adverb before the verb. Lo colocamos antes del verbo o va como en medio. Tiene que decir el sujeto y luego introduce la frecuencia de lo que hace. I sometimes, dice eso y ya la acción. I sometimes play with my children. Sujeto, he, y luego la frecuencia. Ese es el segundo paso.
Quizás por ahí. Sí.
He hardly ever runs in the streets. Luego del sujeto tiene que decir el adverbio. Ese es el segundo paso. Ajá. Y luego la activity de la que usted se quiera referir o indicar. Like my family occasionally go to Guatemala. As an example. Entonces, luego del sujeto, introduzca el adverbio, la frecuencia.
Okay.
Para aprender, si lo que dice de que yo.
Hay que ser. ¿Sí?
Ajá. Es que, por ejemplo, tengo de estas sticky notes, que son para notes, apuntes. Entonces, cuando hay palabras que me dan así como mucha lata, por decirlo así, que me cuestan y quiero aprendérmelas para expandir mi vocabulario, anoto acá algunas y pego esto en un lugar donde yo vaya seguido, como el espejo, en el baño, en un lado de mi laptop, y lo veo, trato de verlo lo más seguido y pensar en él. Y eso me ayuda a memorizar más vocabulario. Entonces, si siente que no se recuerda bien, se olvida, trate de aprendérselos. Ok, como me dice, always and never, ya, eso sí se los puede bien. Always es siempre, never. Pero puede ir poquito a poquito. Agarre uno. Y lo otro que sirve para memorizar es como conectar una palabra con una imagen o con algo, asociar. Como que asocie, usually que se recuerde de algo, algo que casi nunca, que haga seguido, como una activity. Usually y algo que haga a menudo. O si es casi nunca, puede decir hardly ever y asociarlo con algo que casi nunca hace. Pero que no es nunca tampoco, sino casi nunca. Entonces, esos son ejercicios de memorizing. Son ejercicios que se hacen, ¿verdad? Entonces, porque aprender otro idioma requiere memorización, requiere extender, ¿verdad? Aprender más, memorizar más. Entonces, tiene que tener algún tipo de tip, por decirlo así, para ir expandiendo su vocabulario y que se vaya haciendo más amplio, ¿verdad? Más extenso.
Exacto. Sí, inclusive en el caso, bueno, en primer lugar, sí, definitivo, eso es lo que me acaba de mencionar, memorizar, uh-huh. porque sí, quizás me cuesta un poquito armar una oración por lo mismo, porque no tengo mucho vocabulario memorizado, uh-huh. lo mismo. Entonces, a la hora de también armar una oración, digamos así, entonces, me cuesta el unir, cómo unir aquella oración, pues por lo mismo, porque hay poco vocabulario.
Ajá. Trate, si puede, de seguir mi consejo, pruébelo, a ver si le resulta. Cualquiera de esos dos, de asociar o conectar ideas, y el de tener así en una nota, pegado en un lugar, en lugares donde usted transita bastante o mira bastante. Espejo, en el baño, en el cuarto, un lugar donde usted frecuenta. Y cuando lo vea, póngale atención unos segundos, ¿verdad? Como, ajá, eso. Y luego lo vuelve a ver, otra vez le pone atención. Entonces son ejercicios de memorización. Puede probarlos, tal vez le funcione, porque la idea es que usted recuerde, que no se le olvide, sino que mantenga las palabras para que ya en el momento que necesite las utilice.
Exacto, sí. Inclusive son varias. Lo que sí, son varias. De hecho, también ¿cómo se llama? Las palabras para unir una oración también. Eso sí.
¿De dónde va?
Las palabras como para comenzar un párrafo, digamos, como because, como palabras así. Esas son las que igual tengo que memorizar también, porque eso es lo que siento que me está costando un poco.
Sí, así que eso tal vez le puede ayudar. Pruébelo y me cuenta. A ver si le funcionó. Ok, sí. Nelson. I think that we will stop here. Creo que nos vamos a quedar acá entonces. No sé si tiene alguna otra duda o comentario.
Por el momento, dudas no. No. Comentarios sí, la verdad que, me ha ayudado bastante to have and to need. Sí, eso sí.
Mañana los vamos a practicar más. Así que dos perfecto. Días para que quede ya más reforzado ese tema. Porque como ya cerramos unidad 2, entonces es practice. Vamos a practicar. Okay. Ya va a ver las sorpresas de la clase de mañana para que practiquen más.
Perfecto. Okay.
Okay, Nelson. I'm going to let you go in that case. But I hope to see you tomorrow. Nos vemos mañana, ¿verdad?
Thank you.
Cuídese mucho. You're welcome.
Gracias.
Bye. Bye. See you.